journey. So I'm going to talk about this journey though, because you traveled all alone using public transport. And tell us which countries made the biggest impact, and what is it that you were going after? What did you see there that we don't see every day here?
Yeah, the main reason I went on this trip again was, you know, having read all this material about the African continent, and I was just really curious to see it, you know, and I really wanted to see it from the lens of someone who lives that life, like on the day to day, and which is why I chose public transport, and then again going on my own, because it's just something about traveling on your own that gives you a completely different perspective to when you're traveling in the comforts of other people.
That's pretty bold though.
It is.
Talking about bravery.
I can't even go to Cape Town on my own.
I don't have any special friend.
But
how did you convince your family that you weren't insane?
Yeah,
I think it's not an easy I'm originally from Uganda. I know what it means to travel African. I had creature comforts. I'm not going to lie. I'm not going to even compete with you. But it is not an easy place, depending on the villages that you go to in rural areas. So how did you make mom or dad or family comfortable that you're going to be okay?
And you said,
so that was the hardest part, to be honest, like telling my parents that I just told them. And what I tried to do is throughout my trip, just keep them in touch, in contact, just told them what I was doing, just to make sure that they're quite safe as well and they feel okay with my decisions. But it was very hard.
I don't think my mom would have allowed me.
Never. Even at your age.
Like,
yeah.
It was like, it's happening.
If I told my mom, she'd be like, eh?